our signet ring is going to be the first project. I planned mine just using a pencil, a light pencil, and then I went over it with very fine pen. I generally use a marker pen to give me a gray, and then sometimes I'll use a fine pen to shade in and make it look 3D. Look at this beautiful bee that was shaped with a file after it was cut out and then sunk into the shank of the ring. This flat S is put on top of a split ring, and it matches the split ring beautiful, soldered it to it. This Z has got to be the favorite ring that I love. I love spiral shanks, and the way the spiral comes into the very mechanical rectangular Z, it's beautiful and disappears right into the shank. This ring was cut out of wax, but there, look at the transition. That R looks like Rolls Royce. I mean, that ring is beautifully done and finished. This ring uses a wire shank that spirals, an F cut out of flat metal, and a small setting. This ring is actually, you're looking at a reflection in the marble, but it's actually three letters there, and we call that a monogram. This ring has a circular monogram. I can't tell you all the letters. I think it's DMS on that, but it's very beautifully cut out of flat metal. This ring, I can't read the monogram, but there are three letters there, and they're cut out of sheet metal as well. You can have just one letter, and that's a heart, a very thick heart cut out of silver, and then a K is stamped into it. This A was shaped beautifully with a file, and it's just soldered right into the shank, and it's just a beautiful ring. This X was created on a background, and a frame was put around it, and then the shank touches both sides of that box. Very beautiful. Vanessa is the word, the name, and it's cut out of sheet metal beautifully, and then a heart soldered on the other end, and another spiral ring. This is another ring that's one of my favorites. The E, you can get these styles off Google fonts, or you can look under Pinterest under fonts. This is a wire ring that's at, and you can see how beautifully it was shaped with the pliers and soldered together and closed. It's just a beautiful ring solution. This is a wire letter, and one of the links that I gave you to YouTube shows a guy who, or a girl that makes all letters out of wire. Take a look at this thick heart. It's not really separated. It's soldered, but a line has been etched in, and the M is on the other side of that spiral ring. Gigi is a name soldered on these thin little rings, and you have to wear the four rings together. This A is shaped out of wire, and it's very graceful and very beautifully done. And it's one of these rings that doesn't close, so you can wear it on many different fingers. The M is pushed into the N, and this is a wedding ring, and there's two vines cut out and soldered to the shank. Very beautiful. The J is also very elegant, and the little dot on the top is actually connected, and just saw a line in there to separate it. You can take sheet metal and design beautiful letters. Again, go to Pinterest and go to Google Images and look up lettering styles. This E is very much the same. These are diamonds, but you can cut this out of silver sheet metal, and the wire, split wire shank is attached. Notice how these two letters, the S and the J, fit in a circle with a little circle in between, and it's soldered to a nice thin ring. It's a beautiful idea, great design. This is a monogram of three letters, and it's a pendant, but you could make it into a ring. Here's another monogram, or actually two letters, SS, and that could become a ring out of flat sheet metal. So this ring here has been carved in wax with a great deal of precision. So wax carving is very, very popular, and you'll see a lot of rings based on circles. where the letters have to conform, but the negative spaces are equal to the positive spaces, so it really keeps your eye, and it looks like a logo almost. This is another casted ring with the RSG, again in a circular pattern. Here's another casted ring with NA as the letters and the background. And generally you oxidize the background and make the lettering stand out. Another circular pattern of letters forced into a circle. It's very cool when you take a shape and you force letters into it. This is DVD. And notice there's a circle there, but the D's are not circular actually. And the V, the spaces actually equalize each other. This is a logo, but it's very beautifully designed in a circle. That would be great in flat metal on a background. Here's another logo where two letters have been designed. You might take your pencil and make a box and design your lettering. This is three wires soldered together and it looks 3D. And it could be a shank somehow soldered to that combination. This A was cut out of flat metal and designed beautifully, and then the shank is a split shank with two loops on each side, so it's very nice. Here's a box ring. Again, this was cast out of one solid piece of wax where a lot of time was given to that. This is an M cut out of wax. This is another casted ring. Very thin M, very beautifully done, and disappears into the shank. This is a very heavy ring, again made out of wax. And again, this is a great way to carve lettering. Wax carving is hard though, I want to make you understand that. This is brilliant. This is a flat S cut out of sheet metal, and then little pieces of sheet metal were added to make it look like it has very deep dimension and it melts away. This F is done the very same way. The shank comes into the flat F, and then little pieces of sheet metal are added where it touches the shank to make it look very three-dimensional. This was obviously cut out of wax, a very heavy ring. These rings are popular in New York with very thick writing on them. This ring was done out of wax as well, and it has a cluster of diamonds in it in a bezel. This is just a flat piece of metal. It's a pendant, but it could be a ring. You'd have to formalize a way of having the shank soldered to it. And this ring is beautiful by Ketai. It has an A, B, and I think the last letter is A. So it's A, B, A, and it makes the whole top of your finger, the whole crown of the ring. These names were all cut out with a very fine jewelry saw out of flat metal, and they could have been rings. Here's another ring where the shank is soldered to thick letters and a jewel is used, a gemstone with four prong setting. This ring was obviously carved out of wax. It's very rough. The lettering is on the other side of it. Wax is another way to work, but it's very tedious and very hard. This ring was made out of sheet metal, cut with a jewelry saw. And I think there's three letters there. I can only see the H. I can't tell the other letters. This N was soldered to a background, and the shank comes around on both sides and touches the whole side of the N. These two rings were made out of wax, and the letters are just simply carved out. They're done in gold. It's very hard. This looks very complicated, but it's really simple. There's one ring there with designs, sheet metal designs soldered on, and then a rim soldered on both sides. This is a name, but it's very indistinct because the sawing wasn't that great. And I can hardly actually read that, but it's soldered to the shank. Here's a wire letters again, and I told you there's a link that I supplied to you that shows a girl or a man showing you how to make letters out of wire. These are names that are cut out with a very fine jewelry shop out of sheet metal. And they did an excellent job. It's very, very, it takes a lot of time to do that. Here's a beautiful D, and very stylized, and on a wire shank, and it's made out of basically flat metal. This letter is beautiful, it's stylized, and finished very well and soldered to a round shank on the ring. And this 1996 are in German style letters, Gothic letters, and the spaces are just beautiful in that, and that's soldered to a base. This ring was done flat. All the letters were cut out with the jewelry saw again. And of course it's made out of gold. So anyhow, that gives you some idea of some ideas that you can use in yours. Remember, you can use one letter, or you can use a monogram of three letters or two letters.